course. So recently, my our lecturer, Ms. Soleha binti Abdullah, has given us a task. The task is we have to talk about the two topics that she gave to us. The first topic is application of differentiation, and the second topic is application of integration. So me and my friend, aka my teammate, has decided that we are going to talk about the first topic. The topic is application of differentiation. So let's start. What is differentiation? Differentiation is the process of finding the derivative. In calculus, the derivative of a function is the rate of change of the output value with the respect to its input value, whereas differential is the actual change of function. In a simple way, derivative is the measure of how function changes its value as the input change. So right now, we want to know why we use differentiation. We use differentiation because it allows us to find the rate of change. For example, it allows us to find the rate of change of velocity with respect of time. In other words, it means acceleration. It allows us to find the rate of change of x with respect to y, which on the graph of y against x in the gradient of the curve. So right now we know what is differentiation and why we use differentiation. We know in calculus we have many applications of differentiation, such as related rate, concavity, applied maximum and minimum, graph of polynomial function, and other more. So me and my friend has come up with one of these application of differentiation that we want to talk about. The application of differentiation that we choose is graph of polynomial function. My friend Azhari will talk more deeper of in graph of polynomial function. So take this pen.
Thank you, Daus. Now I will explain what polynomial can do. Firstly, a polynomial function is a function such as a quadratic, a Rubik, a quadratic, and so on, involving only non-negative integer power of x. We can give a general definition of a polynomial and define its degree like this. Okay, since polynomials are used to describe curves of various types, people use them in the real world to graph curves, although many of us do not realize it. People in all short profession use polynomials every day. For example, roller coaster designer may use polynomial to describe the curve in the right. It can also be to model different situations, like in the stock market, to see how price will vary over them. Time. In chemistry, gas equation relating geometric parameter can usually be written as polynomial, such as the ideal gas of flow, PV equal nRT, where n is the mole count and r is a proportionality constant. For more information, my friend Zikri will explain how to solve the polynomial.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Zikri Abidi Bajlan. So today I'm going to teach you how to solve a graph of polynomial function. So come on, let's go. So what we have a question. So I already gave a question and a solution for the sum of the small question. So what we have this solution is to find critical points. What we must do is f prime x. 3 x power by 2 is a prime for x power by 3. And negative and minus with 12 x is what we got here, f prime. And plus with 9, so prime. So 1 is 0, right? Equal with 0. So when we have this, we must use our calculator to make this kind of shape. So what we get is 1 and 3. So what when we have this, what we must do is we must replace 1 to the x. So if this x, we must replace it with 1. 1 power by 3 minus with 6 multiply 1 power by 2 plus 9 multiply 1 plus 1, so we can get 5, and then we replace it for 3 needed. 3 power by 3 minus 6 multiply 3 power by 2 plus 9 multiply 3 plus 1, so we get 1. So what we have is critical point. Okay, when we have a critical point, we must go to the next question. The next question is to find the interval of decreasing. So what we have here is we must not use this, but we use this. So we must begin with negative infinity to 1 and 1 to 3, 3 to infinity. So this is interval, and what we have test value, you can, for this of interval, you can get any number between infinity, negative infinity to 1. So I choose 0. And then for 1 to 3, test value 1 to 3, 1, 2, 3, I choose 2 because it's between 4 to 1 and 3. And then 3 to infinity, I choose 4. And then what we have here is we must replace it to this of equation, to this of equation. So 0 minus 1, you can get negative, and 0 minus 3, you can get negative. So negative multiply with negative, you got positive. And 2, 2 minus 1, you can get positive. 2 minus 3, you can get negative. So positive minus, positive multiply with negative, you can get negative. And then 4. 4 minus 1, you get positive. 4 minus 3, you get positive. So positive, positive, you get positive. So to know it decreasing is when the operation is negative. So what is negative in here? So this is the negative. So f is decreasing in the interval of 1 to 3. This. And then with all this information, we can get a maximum point and minimum point. So I already know that the maximum point is 1 to 5 and 3 to 1. So this solution is to solve a problem. The interval fx is concave down. So what we have to solve this question is we must f double prime x. So the before we have a f prime x, but this is double prime. With a first prime, we prime it again. So I already get a 6x minus 12 equal to 0. So minus x 0, 12 go the side, and then 6x equal 12, and x 12. Per with a 6, we can get a 2x equal to 2. So we know this interval is 2. So to interval, we must begin with negative infinity, 2, and 2 until infinity. For test value, you can use anything between negative infinity until 2 and 2 for this interval, and you can use test value for 2 until infinity, anything. So I choose 0 and 3. So replace 0 to the this. And you will get a negative, and 3 for this, and you will get a positive. So negative, positive, how do you know to it concave down or concave out? So if it's negative, so this is concave down. So if it's plus, it's a concave out. So from this, we can know that fx concave down in the interval infinite, negative infinity until 2, because this is not. This is solution. So this solution is to find an inflection point. So what we have here for the solution? 2. So we must replace 2 for the first question. So 2 power by 3 minus 6 multiply 2 power by 2 plus 6 multiply 2 plus 1. So the answer for this, you can get 3. So 2 until 2 point 2, 3 is an inflection point. So what we need to sketch a graph is this information, this maximum and minimum point. This is what we need to sketch a graph. Also, what we need is to find a y-axis. Okay, to find y-axis, you must y equal with any x. X must be the value is 0. So 0 power by 3 minus 6 multiply 0 power by 2 plus 6 plus 9 multiply 0 plus 1. So all these solution, we will get 1. So this is why I choose this one. So from this graph, we must do this. So 0 to 1 to y axis, and go to, from this point, we must pick near with 1. So what near is 1. So we go 1, and then what near is 2. So 2 is the near with a point of 1 to 5. So we go down, because 5 and 3. And then the last is 3. So we go to the 3, and then why the graph is down, because the y, the value of y is go down and not go up, and then we ending with like this. Okay, so this is all for me to solve a graph of polynomial function. So I pass to the other guy.
Hello, assalamualaikum. My name is Syahmi. I'm going to conclude our members' ideas. My first conclusion is, to graph a polynomial functions, you have to find the zeros and their multiplicities. Determine the in behavior and ensure that the final graph has at most n one turning points. Other than that, graphing at a polynomial functions helps to estimate local and global extremas. Lastly, the intermediate values theorem tells us that if f bracket a and f bracket b have opposite signs, then there exists at least one value c between A and B for which F bracket C equals to 0. That's all for my conclusion. And thanks for watching our video. Thank you.